We've got Mayuresh Joshi, our fund manager at Angel Broking, joining us now. Mayuresh, for all those who felt that what we saw in the last 4 days was some sort of a pre-budget rally, all of that is shattered because you're back down, mirroring global cues, and this is the week of F&O expiry. How are you reading the signs?
Afternoon, Mini. Clearly, I think what we probably reading between the lines of what is probably expected to happen in the budget. Expectations are very low, and again, what is happening with the Indian context is a large part of what is happening in the global context. So clearly, what the global markets will do, the Indian markets will follow suit. In that context itself, I think the key overhangs, both on a global and a domestic scale, still continue for the market. So clearly, I think in terms of a range-bound trade or the markets remaining soft, I think this is the perception that a lot of investors stroke traders are carrying into the market, and our own take is the markets are expected to remain soft. And again, as you rightly pointed out, I think expiry around the corner is also creating a huge amount of volatility in the market.
Low expectations, and Nifty now is 51, Mayuresh. Your reaction to that? Tata Motors DVR, I haven't asked that question. How is it looking?
No, clearly, I think as I've been saying for the past so many weeks, we still expect the markets to remain soft based on all these concerns. And an actual re-rating or a gradual re-rating of the markets will only happen once the corporate earnings start reviving. Nobody's expecting that to happen, at least for the next couple of quarters. So I think the hope is with the low base of FY16, FY17 earnings will start looking much better. And again, with expectations of input costs expected to stay benign, I think a lot of the margin expansion that we probably witnessed across sectors would continue. So clearly, I think earnings revival is one thing that the markets would ideally like to watch for, along with growth in the capex cycle, and that would probably hinge on what the budget will deliver in terms of infrastructure spending, rural spending, and so on and so forth. So clearly, in terms of Tata Motors DVR, it is clearly a reflection of how Tata Motors as a stock performs. Globally, the DVR shares trade at a very minuscule discount to the parent company. Here, I think the discount factor is much larger. But clearly, I think with JLR volumes picking up ex-China, new platforms coming through, and though one assumes higher spends happening on advertising, promotion, really, I think FY17 numbers should stack up really well for Tata Motors. So again, I think we remain optimistic on Tata Motors / Tata Motors DVR.
Right, to hold your thoughts, Mayuresh, we'll get you more on Nifty 51, even though it's going to be called Nifty 50, I hear. But let's quickly get you a sense of why the rejig has happened. Interestingly, Cain and Vedanta and PNB have all three moved out of the Nifty, and we've got three new additions. What is the rationale? What does it mean for the Nifty? My colleague Piyush Jain puts the move in context for us. Piyush.
Nifty in its periodic revision has announced the new entry into the index. The stocks are Aurobindo Pharma, Tata Motors DVR, Aisha Motors and Bharati Infratel. Similarly, the outgoing stocks, they are PNB, Cain India and Vedanta. Now, what is important for the viewers to know is that this is periodic revision based on the market cap of the stocks. So, as the new entrants, they have gained market cap, they have made an entry into the index. Now, what it does is all the index-linked funds now basically will have to make adjustment and will have to take exposure in the new stocks. And what it does is it increases the liquidity in these stocks. Thereby, there will be more participation in the stocks and also some price action towards the positive side will be seen. Similarly, on the outgoing stocks, there will be a fund outflow from these stocks, so which means near-term selling pressure could be seen in these stocks. Also, the incoming stocks like Aurobindo Pharma and Tata Motors DVR, they especially are being rated very highly by the analysts, giving them about 40% upside from the current estimates. And also in particular, Tata Motors DVR, which is trading somewhere around 30 to 40% discount to the main Tata Motors listed stock, it means that this entry is going to increase the liquidity in the stock and perhaps will reduce the discount which it is trading at present. So right. Overall, it seems that the viewers basically should take a close look at these stocks and in particular Tata Motors DVR.
Absolutely, and the market's already looking very closely at Tata Motors DVR. The stock is up sharply. Moving now to the topic all of us are discussing, the much-awaited budget session of Parliament kicks off today. This will be the make-or-break session ahead of the budget. Before the session, President Pranab Mukherjee reiterated that the government is committed towards the social security of the poor through their various social security scheme. Listen in.
The poorest of the poor are entitled to the first charge on the nation's resources. Removing the scourge of poverty and destitution is our most sacred responsibility. My government is pledged to making this goal possible through financial inclusion and social security.
And moving on to the Prime Minister, at a time when political strife has gripped the country, Prime Minister Narendra Modi says constructive criticism should be the only way to strengthen the institution of democracy. Listen in.
सदन का उपयोग गहन विचार विमर्श के लिए होना चाहिए, सरकार की भी भरपूर आलोचना होनी चाहिए, सरकार की कमियां भी उजागर होनी चाहिए, और वही एक मार्ग है लोकतंत्र को मजबूत बनाने का, जन सामान्य की आशा आकांक्षाओं को परिपूर्ण करने का.
That's the Prime Minister speaking, and undoubtedly it's an effort to really get the opposition to discuss some of the matter. And there is so much of strife that we've gone into this session with what's happened with the Jatta agitation, what's happened in JNU, and a whole lot of concerns being raised out there. Mayuresh still with us. Mayuresh, you know, we've touched upon the budget. We've touched upon the fact that, you know, the global volatility is what is dominating and the expectations are very little. But there is also the fear of that capital gains issue, the dividend tax issue, all of that coming to roost. Now, the markets are going into this budget with nervousness. Briefly, because I also have some stocks to talk to you about, briefly tell me, what are the two things that the markets are scared of, and what are the two things that could get the markets up and running in this budget?
Not sure what the markets are scared of. I think there are a lot of factors that the markets are scared of at this point of time, Mini. But clearly, if you talk about what the expectations from the budget are, I think the markets clearly want some amount of leeway happening on the fiscal consolidation numbers, which effectively means that the exchequer will have more leeway to do spending in terms of infrastructure, rural spending, so on and so forth. Now, if you talk about the receipts, both on the direct front and indirect front, I think the indirect front has shown huge amount of surge in the year gone by. And again, I think the expectations are pretty large on that front. Again, I think the real income growth or the nominal GDP growth that we've probably seen, I think that will grow at a very tepid pace. So I think the direct tax collections will be a little bit softer in our opinion. Having said that, I think the subsidy payouts, the commissioning on the 7th pay commission, the Europe, I think that's going to take some amount of sheen, at least as far as the deficit numbers are concerned. So clearly, I think it's going to be a fine balancing act that the markets are probably expected to probably witness that the finance minister might do. And that only the budget will relay on budget day. So clearly, I think expectations are extremely soft. You're probably talking about markets expecting huge amount of spending cuts to come through, and related to the long-term capital gain tax. I think that's a fear and an uncertainty that the markets are probably working at this point of time. But again, I think it's the budget day that will decide what is probably expected to happen.
There was a lot talked about in terms of corporate tax rationalization and removal of exemptions, Mayuresh. Is that a worry as well, or is that priced in?
Look, it's not a worry part in my opinion. Clearly, he's given a roadmap in the last budget, and again, I think it's going to happen over a longer period of time, over the next 3 to 4 years. So I think the corporate tax slabs are going to come down, and once these tax slabs come down, I think the obvious conclusion is that some exemptions will have to go. So clearly, I think this is one factor that the markets are probably cognizant about. So I don't think that the markets are nervous at all in terms of what the roadmap has been given, at least on the corporate tax structure.
But on exemptions, there is a bit of apprehension from corporate India, because you know that a lot of companies do benefit from exemptions and tax ops. Have you done any back of the envelope calculations to see which are the companies which are going to be hit if exemptions are removed?
No, I think we've not done that, unfortunately. But I think if you look at the larger scheme of things, I think it's a direction that the budget probably gives in what the economy might head to over the next year, year and a half, 2 years. So I think it's more a financial accounting presentation for the last year and what expectations are greatly from where the economy is heading. So clearly, I think not worked out anything on the exemption part. But yes, I think if you talk about excise duties, if you talk about certain rebates, if you talk about certain exemptions generally for the corporate sector as a whole, I think a few sectors are expected to do well. A few sectors might get hit with increase in excise duty and taxes.
Very quickly, last question. As a fund manager, what are you telling your clients? Any counters or stocks which are crying to be bought right now, or would you say take a break from markets?
No, clearly, I've been repeatedly saying that in terms of fresh investment corpus, only 15% should get into the market. You should be sitting on cash. And wisely, I think the capital allocation has to be done over a gradual, in a gradual manner over a period of time. Having said that, probably I think one should really wait for the budget now because it's hardly 3 or 4 days away. So one should not be rushing into the markets at this point of time. Let us see what the budget has to offer. Let us see how the global volatility pays out over the next few weeks. And then we'll probably take a larger call in terms of what stocks can be bought out. But largely, I think in a thematic sense, pharma selectively, cement, stroke infrastructure selectively, autos selectively, a large part of the larger private sector banks selectively. I think these pockets are reasonably looking better.
Fair enough. Mayuresh, we leave it there. Thanks so much for joining us. Up ahead, we talk budget wish lists in the healthcare sector with Sunita Reddy of Apollo Hospitals. That's coming up for you.